Another announcement that we expect from the White House, an official coordinator for the monkeypox outbreak will be assigned. Two sources report the Biden administration is working on adding a monkeypox coordinator to the staff, but they have not hired anyone yet. This person would be responsible in assisting the federal government's response. 2,900 cases of the virus have been confirmed here in the U.S., including 23 right here in Central Florida.
Russia announced today that after 2024, it will no longer participate in the International Space Station. The news comes amid spiking tension between the U.S. and Russia over the war in Ukraine. Our Scott Heidler joins us from the Kennedy Space Center. This has a wide and deep impact, doesn't it, Scott?
It sure does. And it's very obvious that if there is, if they deactivate, the Russians deactivate their side of the International Space Station, it'll have a major impact on the overall station's operation, but also on science. Well, there's some skepticism that the Russians will actually pull the plug after 2024.
Well, I always have to take it with a grain of salt whenever I hear anything from the Russians, especially to do with space. They've made so many announcements and threats.
But this time might be different. Backing out after 24, an idea that's been floated before.
So I think there may be something actually to this particular announcement.
The impact will be on two fronts. The U.S. and Russia are the main stakeholders in the station. They both ferry astronauts up to the ISS, the U.S. stepping up its pace thanks to SpaceX crewed launches over the last few years, reducing the reliance on Russia's Soyuz. The Russian half of the station itself is large and important for propulsion, keeping the station in the right orbit. But the overall impact of a Russian withdrawal would hit the critical science performed on the ISS. Without the Russians, NASA and the international partner astronauts will have much more operational work to do.
There's virtually no time then left for doing science. Any science that does take place will have to be done in an autonomous way. And that kind of defeats the purpose of having humans flying the space mission.
So there's a thought that more NASA funding might need to be diverted to the commercial space station programs. Now, that's something if the ISS, of course, might need to be deactivated, retired earlier than the scheduled 2030 timeframe. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.